Hello traders, it's Iliya here and I'm so glad to see you on my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm gonna break down trading plans. So I posted a questions tab in Instagram and there was one about trading plans. So I agreed to share my trading plan with that person, but then a lot of you guys came over to ask for it. So I wanted to please everyone. So right now I'm gonna share my trading plan, the outlook of it and absolutely everything actually. And I really hope this will help you out. So the link will be included down in the description. And on this video, this will be a short video just describing what trading plan is, what has to be included, and showing you my personal one and giving you some key notes. So if you're excited about it, make sure to hit the subscribe button if you still haven't, and let's get into the video. Alright, writing down your trading plan and why is it so important? So let's begin with what is a trading plan? Well, a trading plan is just a plan, just a document that describes in details how you're going to trade the market. So you know that before setting up a new business, you will always need a business plan to present first before getting the investors and even before opening a company. So this is the same with trading, but a lot of traders don't really get this perspective about trading. They think of it as a gamble or some sort of a game, but it's really a business. You still have to have a business plan in order to succeed in this business. And your trading plan, which includes absolutely everything that you trade, that you watch, that you look for, how do you execute, what is your risk, money management, absolutely everything should be written down. So you can write it down on your laptop in a all those journaling apps like Evernote or just in a single Word document as I've always done or by hand, and you have to print it out and stuck it onto your wall or keep it close to you like on the desk, and you have to read it like every day. Why? Well, I was a victim of that. I've had numerous trading plans and I still have them, and this one I'm going to share with you is a very recent one, but I'm always making changes and my trading plans are always very long because I tend to include every single detail in order to really embed it in my mind. And that is why I'm telling you right now to stick it onto your wall and desk, because you really have to remember it and you really have to trade it. Like, trade your plan, plan your trade your plan, you know, always following your trading plan. That's what every trader says, but it's really important that you grasp the concept of your trading plan and you execute everything that is written. And in order to do this, you have to read it and to memorize it. And it's best when you write it down, print it out, read it every morning before trading, and I promise you, your trading will skyrocket. So what does a trading plan include? Well, first, your routine. That's how my trading plan looks. Make sure to play with it like however you want, but that is my kind of my structured way of presenting my plan. So my routine, the time you're trading, the time you're analyzing, when do you get up, what do you do, how do you approach your trading day? It's important for you guys to have a specific way of approaching your trading day. Sometimes you might wake up very tired, exhausted, or maybe you have something going on with your personal lives and you don't feel well. Don't trade, because usually those emotions start to mess up with your mind. You're nervous and you try to kind of express your nerves into the market, which is the worst thing you can do, because you say, oh, I'm super angry, I want to make some profits right now, so let's get into the market. No, even if you're sick, you're ill, don't trade. So how do you approach your trading day? Do you have a morning ritual? Me personally, I meditate, I go for a jog outside, or I just refresh my body, listen to some music, relaxing ones, and I just try to kickstart my day, because usually in the morning I'm sleepy, so I need to do something to wake up. And how do you get into the zone? So before starting to trade, you really have to get concentrated, calm, collective, and relaxed, as Mark Douglas says. So second point, your technical analysis tools and methodologies. How do you identify a trend, a zone, a level, support and resistance? How do you do it? Describe it. Do you catch the wicks? Do you do the mirror levels that got tapped from the other side and retested from the other? How do you identify them? And what tools are you going to use? trend lines, pips, channels, candlesticks, indicators, head and shoulders, all of them are present, but you just have to figure out which one works for you and which one are you going to use. And point 2.1, your process of analysis. That's how do you do it. The first one was what tools do you use, and then how do you do it. So from which time frame do you start? Which is your most important time frame? Which is your higher time frame that you're going to analyze, and which is your the lowest one? So for example, me personally, I start always from the daily. I have a look at the daily picture, then I drop to the 4-hourly. I used to drop to the 8-hourly as well to have a look how Asian session develops. But right now I'm doing daily 4-hour, 1-hour. That's my top-down analysis. And what are you looking for on the specific time frames? So every time frame has to have a purpose for you. For example, the daily will show you the trend, the 4-hourly will show you the structure, will show you the entries, the hourly will give you the tightest entries, and on the 15-minute you can even look for scalping trades. But you have to identify this and you have to write it down. So where do you identify the trend, the levels, and which time frame? Yeah, I said that. All right, let's proceed. Important notes, that's something you may haven't heard of, but that has been a game changer for me personally. So it's super important to journal your trades. I think I've said that quite a lot of times in my previous videos, as this is the way, guys, for you to come up with your important notes. So those are kind of specific things, specific aspects that you need to pay attention to. For example, you kept losing after trading pin bars. Well, in your important notes, you should have don't trade pin bars. In my notes, you will see I have don't trade on Monday on Friday because I tend to lose. I don't know why, but I always lose on Monday and Friday. And as I journal my trades, the day I trade, I found out that Mondays and Fridays don't work for me. So just stick it in my important notes and don't trade. This really depends on you because every trader is different and every trader will have different important notes. But it's pretty important to include them and print them out. So before taking a trade, make sure to quickly have a look at your important notes and decide if this is a trade you should be taking or not. Money management plan, it's crucial, guys. So this is where you really accept trading as a business. You have to identify your risk per trade, how many trades you're going to take, how much are you willing to risk per day and per week, and what is your target in percentages or in pips, however you like to calculate it. So that's pretty important, and I will show you my personal one. I haven't shared this before, but I'm doing everything for you guys, so make sure to see how I've structured it, and then you can judge how do you want to kind of to make it to your own taste. But it's crucial to have this and to follow it, because that's what makes a trader profitable and a trader, a real trader, not a gambler. So then you have your ways of entries. So you can be detailed here or you can just describe. I've always been a fan of like getting to feel the trade. So if I see a candle formation at that level when the 4-hourly aligns with the daily and all that stuff, then you just wait for that entry. But it could be absolutely everything and it's different for everyone. But you just have to describe how you usually enter the markets, what tools you use for it, what candlestick formations. In my trading plan, in that trading plan I had, it was for candlestick formations to test how they work, and they work perfectly because candlestick formation is price action, market structure. That's the way I trade and it really works. But it could be indicators, candlesticks, are you using limiter, stop orders, and it's all different, guys, and you have to decide it for yourself. And finally, some psychology notes. Those are your own notes or psychology or rules, advice that you've read in books and videos. So this section of your trading plan will always expand. I have a whole document, a whole book with a psychology advice, with things I've realized. I have my journals as well, but you have to include like the most important aspects that you think are crucial for your trading. So you will learn new things every day, so make sure to document everything because that's a huge process and your trading plan will always change. Like I have a new trading plan now, but this was like the most well-structured for you guys. Right now I don't write trading plans like this. Is just one page that I'm able to to include everything I do, but with this trading plan, I really think it will help you develop your own. So let's go right now to have a look at my trading plan and give you some key points. Okay, here's my trading plan, guys. As you can see, my trading day, that's how it starts. Get up early, meditate, that's my process. That's how I start my day and that's how I get into the zone. So select only 1 to 3 setups. That's how I stay concentrated on only 3 setups. So I don't trade 30 pairs. I don't trade 10 setups per day. For me, less is more. And a few notes here. Wait very patiently. I trade around New York Open. You see it's super detailed. When do I trade? What do I do? No rush needed, possible entries late at night. Then your trading system. Here you identify your tools and how do you do it? What's your process? Weekly key levels, how do you identify them? How do you mark them on your charts? Daily time frame, where the analysis begins. What do you do there? Trend lines, trends, candlestick formations, details about the candlestick formations, daily Fibonacci, how do you use them? Golden pocket is for best entries. Mark and wait for the daily levels to get reached, another important point. So then I have support and resistance. How do I identify support and resistance in trending markets? Swing points, 2 bounces, you see details, price zones, draw them with rectangles. That's how I draw, write down my trading plans with details, because that's really sticks into your head and you just, you have to relearn by heart your trading plan. Supply demand zones, Fibonacci levels, we already had that. So 4-hour time frame is my key. As day trader, this is more of a swing trading plan, but your 4-hour, you have to identify your key time frame. So for scalpers, it may be the hourly. For swing traders, it may be the daily or the 4-hourly. And for position traders, it may be the daily and weekly. So it really depends on you. And describe what do you do on your 4-hourly time frame. Take the best setups with clear break and retests. How is price moving? In what formation are we? Double top, double bottom, head and shoulders. In order for reversal formation to be correct, we need a broken trend line. Again, details. For trend continuations, what do I do? FIPS. 4-hour EMA, another indicator I use. How do I use it? Liquidity zones, that's something I haven't spoken about, but I will make sure to do. Make sure to let me know down in the comments if you want to see videos about it. I must identify zones. How? Where price rejects violently. When tapping into a liquidity zone, price reacts immediately. And you see, I've underlined this. All important things. Then another point, another tool I use. Support and resistance, daily highs and lows. Break-even rule, how do I go break-even and how do I manage my trade? For stop-loss on profit, wait for hourly pullback to the EMA or for clear 4-hourly price action. Here are my important notes. You see color through, no trades, do not trade. Those are the mistakes I kept making. So you see, I've clearly expressed them here I just stopped making them. Another things that I've realized, rules plus discipline plus patience equals success. Always take profits when they are. Don't turn into a greedy pig. Stay out of major news. Never close a trade. Correlation. Yes is more. Yeah, you have. And here's the most important part, guys. I think you will really love this. So make sure to check it out. 2% of my account per trade. My maximum loss. I have identified. How many trades I take per week. What is my target? What is my win rate? What is my risk to reward ratio? How much do I target? A few notes here. And here as a little bit of motivation, if you want to achieve 6 figures, what do you need to do? Always think long term and a few notes. And I think this one you will really like because it's, I have this stuck on my wall only right now because this helps me be concentrated on the long term. Then entries, guys, check those out. Bullish, bearish, engulf, those are the formations I usually trade and I used to trade on the 4-hourly. Everything is described here again with details. Above the midpoint of the body, for example, the closer, you will see it. I don't want to ramp a lot on this video. And then psychology notes. I had a lot going on here, but I just didn't want to make this trading plan a burden. So I just included the most important ones that I've learned from Mark Douglas's book. I'm a consistent runner because 7 points, read them and make sure to embed it into your mind. and my favorite five rules, my favorite, anything can happen. This is my most favorite. You don't need to know what's going to happen next in order to make money. Random distribution between wins and losses. An edge is nothing more than an indication of higher probability. That's what I spoke on my recent Instagram post, that you never know what's going to happen and you just need that edge that will kind of give you the odds in your favor, turn the odds in your favor. And every moment in the market is unique. There is never a moment that the same traders will enter the same market at the same time on the same structure. Every moment is unique. So that's for this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to leave me some feedback down in the comments so I really know that this was beneficial for you. Make sure to come with me again with questions. I really love this and I promise to do more of those videos during that year. But in order to do this, I need your support and I need your questions, because if you ask questions, I get topics to make, and that's how the flow keeps flowing. So again, make sure to hit the like button and see you on my next video. Thank you.